thanks for joining us here on World Tech Update. I'm Nick Barber. We're back here at the IFA Consumer Electronics Show in Berlin with news we didn't get to last time. We'll start our show this week with the vanishing tablets at Samsung's booth. Last week, we told you about the launch of the Galaxy Tab 7.7. After being on display for less than 2 days, Samsung removed every trace of their existence from the booth. A PR spokesman at the booth had little to say.
We took it away yesterday. It's not here. When we get a court, official communication from the court, then we'll be able to comment, but not before.
Okay. And which court has ordered you to take it away?
No. All I can tell you, when we get official communication from the Dusseldorf court, we can comment.
On August 25th, the Dusseldorf court upheld a preliminary injunction ordering Samsung to stop selling the Galaxy Tab 10.1 in Germany. Samsung's lawyers must have anticipated the possibility that the court's ruling would apply to the smaller tablet, too. Samsung covered up the signage for the tablet. You can see here in the before and after images. In this image, a backlit sign for the Galaxy Tab 7.7 is visible, but by Sunday, it was replaced with an advertisement for the Note. On one of the walls of the booth, it looked as if a piece of text was slapped over what previously advertised the Tab 7.7. And you can see in this video that the graphic shot on Friday is different from the one displayed on Sunday. Removing the tablet from the stands means tens of thousands of consumers and press didn't get a chance to try it out. But the bad news doesn't stop there for the Korean electronics maker. Reviews are starting to roll in for the Galaxy Note, the 5.3-inch tablet-smartphone hybrid. Many seem to be scratching their heads about the size and the stylus that it uses.
I think the Galaxy Note is kind of an interesting product. In some ways, it's sort of a throwback, right? It's a 5-inch phone with a stylus. It almost feels like a PDA. You know, the reality is large phones have never done particularly well. The Dell Streak didn't do particularly well. I think Samsung's going to be pretty challenged with this product. Not sure that people really miss the stylus.
We'll find out whether or not the tablet smartphone is a success when it launches later this year. Sony's taking a different approach to 3D and is planning to offer the personal 3D viewer as an alternative to 3D televisions. It'll be out by the end of the year, but Sony didn't provide pricing details.
We can provide with this gadget, but you are in your home, that home theater experience, that means a 750-inch screen in the 20-meter distance in your home. So thanks to our OLED technology, that means organic light emitted diode that can provide a very clear picture you haven't experienced yet.
It can be connected to a 3D camcorder for a live view of what's being shot or used for movies and gaming. It also has headphones. While the 3D viewer may be isolating, it's not like you can enjoy it with your friends. I had a chance to try it and it's pretty unique. The 3D effect is quite good and the picture is clear and bright. It takes a moment to focus the headset, but after that, it can just sit comfortably on your head. Staying with 3D, LG debuted its Dual Play technology, hoping to entice gamers into buying their 3D TVs. Normally in multiplayer games, the screen is split, but with Dual Play, gamers can view the full screen with each player seeing a separate image. 3D TVs work by sending different images to each eye, and Dual Play uses that to its advantage by sending one set of images to one player and another set to another player. Where typical polarized 3D glasses would have a left and right eye, the Dual Play glasses have one set with two left eyes and another set with two right eyes. Dual Play works with any LG Cinema 3D TV, and the glasses will be shipping along with the LW980 series televisions by the end of September. LG also said users can make their own Dual Play glasses simply by switching out lenses. Sony announced a similar idea at E3 back in June, but that TV uses active shutter 3D glasses and measures only 24 inches. Panasonic's also betting big on 3D and has a big focus on content. It announced a deal to broadcast the 2012 London Olympic Games live in 3D. It will use the AG 3DP1. Panasonic, along with the Olympic Broadcast Services, plans to produce more than 10 hours a day of 3D content from the games. Panasonic has a lot riding on 3D, and the lack of content is limiting adoption of the format. So it's no wonder that Panasonic will try to produce as much 3D content as possible from an event that has worldwide appeal. Hoping to speed up content creation for regular consumers, the company debuted its newest 3D camcorder, the HDC Z10000. It has a 6.5 megapixel sensor and can shoot 1080p HD video. It also has two new image stabilization systems, which according to Panasonic makes it easier to shoot in low light. This marks the second year that Panasonic introduced a 3D camcorder during the show, continuing its push for the format. This could be the future of window shopping. See something you like, learn more about it, and buy it without even entering the store. It's called the Interactive Display Window and is a project from Germany's Fraunhofer Institute. The system is made of a motion tracker and a display. It can detect gestures of customers and provide them with more information on products. The motion tracker was a built-from-scratch device that the team has been working on for 10 years, even before anything like the Microsoft Kinect sensor hit the market. In fact, Fraunhofer said a Kinect sensor could be used, though theirs is specially tailored for the prototype project, with infrared lights and tracking cameras.
The window is a problem for us because it's reflecting light, it's reflecting pictures and so on. This is a real problem, but we found a solution that's working very well right now. And on the other hand, one of the biggest problems is to teach the user how to actually do it.
Fraunhofer didn't say what companies they're working with to further the project. Sure, your iPhone can send text messages and get your email and make phone calls, but what about control your vacuum cleaner? LG showed off its HomeBot 2.0 that can be controlled by your iPhone. And it doesn't just vacuum, it can patrol your home when you're not there. It's capable of sending live images back to your phone as it moves around your home. It'll even map the rooms in your house. It's on sale now in Korea for about $800. And if an iPhone-controlled vacuum cleaner wasn't enough, how about a robotic window washer? Called Windoro, it's a two-part system. One side goes on the outside of the glass, and the other on the inside, and it's held together by magnets. It can work on windows up to 1 inch thick, but it'd be a tough task to mount the outer unit if you're in a high rise, so for now, it might just be better to stick with hand washing. Well, that's our show for this week. Thanks for joining us here on World Tech Update. Next week, I'll be back in Boston, but I'm on the road again soon, this time to Tokyo for CTEX, so be sure to mark your calendars. To find out what's coming up on every week's program, be sure to follow us on Facebook and Twitter. As we head out this week, we'll leave you with some sights of IFA. I'm Nick Barber, and for all of us here at the IDG News Service, thanks for watching, and we hope to see you next week.